15-year-old Pakistani girl critically injured by Taliban militants does not have significant brain damage. That is good. That is word from Malala Yousafzai's doctors in Birmingham, England. They say Malala is walking with little help, and she appears to remember things that happened before she was shot. Malala was attacked for promoting a girl's right to an education. She was reunited with her family yesterday, and her father thanked her doctors in Pakistan and England.
Right treatment, at the right place, at the right time. And I'll say that, of course, an attacker who was, who could be called the agent of Satan, he attacked. But after that, I found angels on all my side.
The attack on Malala has outraged people around the world. It also shed light on the challenges of Pakistani girls that they face in just trying to get an education. Zubeida Mustafa has spent more than three decades covering issues just like that in Pakistan. She was the first woman to work in the country's mainstream media. Her work has earned her a Lifetime Achievement Award from the International Women's Media Foundation. And Zubeida Mustafa, she's joining us from Los Angeles. First of all, congratulations. Really such an honor to be able to even speak with you about what is taking place here. You actually started a newspaper, Dawn, back in 1975. For years, you're the only one, the only woman in the newsroom. What was that like for you?
Thank you. I think it was really very great being there. Of course, in the beginning, there was, I wouldn't say uphill, but it was a challenge to establish myself and to prove myself. But once I had done it, it was quite easygoing because of all the cooperation I received. And in some ways, I even found it an advantage being a woman because I could go into areas where a man would not have been allowed. You know what Pakistan is. It's a very segregated society. And I could enter, say, the refugee camps. I'd been to the border areas and I could go and talk to the women there when no one would have talked to them. It was the men who were doing all the talking. Or even in our shanty towns in Karachi itself. Sure. I remember for the elections, I could go and talk to the women and ask them what they wanted from the leaders.
Tell me a little bit about what is happening now. I mean, when you look at this, fast forward from the 70s, now 2012, and you have this Pakistani schoolgirl who is the target for assassination by the Taliban, shooting her in the head because she believes in just rights for girls to have an education. What do you make of what is taking place in your country?
Well, I think Malala has proved what we had been feeling for quite some time, that it was generally being said as though the Pakistanis do not want to educate the girls, or the parents are conservative, and they don't want to send the girls to school. But I think that period has long passed. Now people do value education and even education for girls. So what happened to Malala? There was so much shock and a sense of outrage. And it, in a way, breached the barrier of silence, which people didn't want to speak about, maybe out of fear because what the Taliban were doing. But now it seems that they've come into the open and there's been so much support for her all over the country, from men as well as women.
All over the world support for this young girl.
Yes.
What do you make of the strength of the Taliban in Pakistan? Because so many people have come forward to support this little girl. Are they as strong as we think they are here in the United States?
Yes, I think that is true. Actually, with the Taliban, the problem is they don't have so much support, but they are armed. And if the rest of the population is unarmed, so it gives them a certain kind of power, which in a way gives the wrong impression as though they are the one who are really dominating the scene. They are doing it with the help of their weapons.
Well, Ms. Mustafa, we congratulate you on your work, on your Lifetime Achievement Award, and the work that you continue to do inside of Pakistan to bring change there for women and for your society. Thanks again. Appreciate